very good morning for our first Blackpool vlog of 2016, because we are here at
the Blackpool Tower.
Aye.
With 4D cinema experience, of course. Of course, it's me, Shawn Sandbrook.
And me, Charlotte Chosherick.
Yeah, because we're going to be doing the mailing stuff. I mean, you've never done it before,
I've
have
never
you?
Done it, yeah.
So we thought, we're coming down here for the weekend. Blackpool Pleasure Beach opens tomorrow for its brand new season. Let's come down, put our brand new camera to the test. You might have noticed already, the camera quality has improved a lot. I mean, I'm testing it out today. So when we go to Madame Tussauds, the Sea Life Centre, we'll be sort of doing some funny angles and stuff to try out this brand new camera. I mean, it looks good. I mean, you should be able to hear us a lot better. It's got like a surround sound thing on. Yeah, it's just a lot cooler. And in our brand new behind the scenes video that'll be coming to the channel in a few weeks, I'll show you a bit more about our camera equipment and stuff as well. So basically, here in Blackpool, you've got, of course, the tower with 4D cinema, which is fantastic. I mean, I think you're really going to like it.
Yeah.
Then we're going to head down and do the dungeon. Obviously, we can't take the camera inside, but we'll give you our review. And it's actually Charlotte's first time doing the dungeon, so we'll give you Charlotte's review when we come out. And of course, we're going to go down to Madame Tussauds, show you around there. And you've never done a Madame Tussauds before
we get to
either.
Meet Jeremy Kyle.
That's what she's bothered about. Jeremy Kyle. Out of all the celebrities in the world, you know, Jeremy Kyle.
I love Jeremy.
I'm surprised she's not more bothered about Justin Bieber, you know.
Yeah, mate.
Yeah. And of course, the Sea Life as well, which is one of the best in the UK. It's really well themed. So we'll start off, we're going to the 4D cinema, and we'll see you in the lift, heading up to the top of Blackpool Tower. First time for Charlotte, you looking forward to it?
Yeah.
It's going to be good. And like I said, we'll put this camera to the test as well, show you some of the zoom features and stuff. It's going to be good. Oh, yeah.
Tower,
you'll be fine in here.
If you do have any other questions, there is always a staff member at the top, so they jump into us.
We have arrived.
What's that?
My ears are
popped. Here we go. Wow. Did you enjoy the 4D cinema, Charlotte?
Yeah, it was really good actually.
What are you into it? Got a bit of Kylie in your head now, a bit of All the Lovers, yeah. Yeah. It's nice to be able to see it without the scaffolding.
What would you do
just
if I
about.
Went through it?
What would I do if you went through it?
Yeah.
There you go. But yeah, basically, if you've never seen the 4D cinema before, you know, you get a bit of Kylie, All the Lovers. It's about 5 or 6 minutes, you know, it's quite got quite a good length to it. It's not like a really short sort of 4D film. And it's based on sort of the history, it shows you the history of the tower, how it was built. Obviously, it's all a recreation, but it's still, you know, it's really good. I really enjoy it. It's probably one of my favourite 4D cinemas, along with Marvel superheroes at Madame Tussauds. You taking pictures?
I am.
There you go.
I'd
hide it for a bit. Needs a bit of a clean, doesn't it?
It does, you can't
when,
see.
When it, I remember when it first opened, I came up here, it was really like...
You can't see.
It was really clean. I mean, you can see through just about, but... Tell you what, the paintwork looks really good on the tower, though. I mean... you know, it just needs a bit of a... You scared?
No, I'm
on. I think you need to do a jump on it.
Jump on
it. Look.
You're back. What would you give the 4D cinema out of 10?
I'm going to give it a 6.
6 out of 10?
Yeah.
What do you prefer, that one or the one for the London Eye? Because obviously if you've done both, it's quite a similar...
I'd probably say the London Eye one.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What about Kylie though? Bit of All the Lovers, did not do it for you? Oh, see, I like Kylie, I like a bit of Kylie. I mean, normally it shows you the Isle of Man in the film, and because Charlotte, I don't know if you know, the Isle of Man is over there. But as you can see... Yeah, it's an island.
Wow. Is it part of this country?
Yeah, yeah. But it's pretty much, I don't know how far, it can't be that far. I'd say, I'm going to make a guesstimate now and say it's about 20 to 25 miles, I would say, in that direction. Because you can see quite a fair way. I mean, as you said, by the gill in the lift, I mean, you know, it's 380 feet, did you say? Something like that. I don't know. I don't know the exact facts. I'm sure a Blackpool resident will have found this vlog and will let me know the height. Just look at this camera quality then, let's have a little look. I mean, you look at this now, you can really see the details on my face. I mean, I know that's all what you want to see at home while you're eating your peanuts, you know. But look at the detail on Charlotte's face there, you know. Right? Just wave your hair about for me. There you go. It really is the detail justice. I mean, this is good though. I mean, I like how they sort of branded it the same as the London Eye.
Yeah.
If you go to Sydney, they've also got the Sydney Tower Eye. I mean, I've not been lucky enough to go and see it, obviously, but yeah, it's good. I mean, this, perfectly safe. Don't like it. What you want to do is do a bit of a run up at it, you see. You want to start over here. Penny press. And you want to have a bit of a run at it. There you go. Now it's Charlotte's turn. I'll count you in. Ready?
I'm going to do it, viewers.
3, 2, 1. What was that? I didn't hear her. That'll do. What do you think to it up here? Obviously, you can't really see much today. Yeah, I mean, it's a bit condensated. This one's fine. This is all right. But as you can see, it would actually be a lot cleaner if they sort of took this off, because if you look here...
Can it, like some sort of brush and went...
You see this here?
Yeah, it's like
do
you know when you're blowing your eyes down? And it's got that protective cover.
Yeah, it's got
it's a protective cover.
Yeah. There you go, you see the bus down there. So like I say, you can't see the Isle of Man. Got the North Pier just over there. The North Pier has always been a bit boring. I mean, it's Charlotte's first proper time in Blackpool, isn't it, really? I mean, you've done the Merlion stuff. The Pleasure Beach, but never the Merlion stuff. I'm getting confused. North Pier. Central Pier, which obviously is February 2016 at the moment. So you can see there's no gondolas on the Ferris wheel. Let's put this zoom to the test then, see what we can get. I mean, when I normally start zooming in, the quality starts to sort of go, but if you look at this, you can tell the camera quality is a lot better.
That looks like some of a horror film.
What? This camera quality?
No, that Ferris wheel.
It does, doesn't it? So hopefully this will really make your theme park worldwide experience even better. I mean, I'm always looking to invest in new equipment for you guys. Obviously this isn't looking too great through the glass up here, but considering, I think it's good. I mean, let's zoom in a little bit down to the big one. There we go, I mean, look at that. Charlotte's enjoying the music. I can't remember if they used to play music up here or not. I don't think they did, or if they did, it was like a theme soundtrack. I don't remember like chart music playing. What I also like about up here is Coral Island have got their little advert on the roof. You spot Coral Island from up here. There you go.
You've got 10 seconds.
10 seconds? It doesn't help the fact I've zoomed in on it. But hopefully we'll be riding the big one tomorrow, subject to the wind. Same with the tower if you do ever come here. If it is really windy, then the tower won't be open. Of course, with it being a Merlion attraction, you can use your annual pass. Yeah, but they also do a big ticket, so if you don't have a Merlion attraction, you can buy the big ticket, which includes all the attractions that you're going to see us do today, basically.
I'm now going to give you a demonstration of the information we have here at the Blackpool Tower.
With 4D cinema experience.
Cinema.
Can't forget that bit, it's important bit.
Here we have Blackpool in the daytime and in the nighttime.
Daytime.
Daytime and nighttime. Here we have the Blackpool Pleasure Beach.
Pleasure Beach was founded in 1800, you're not giving me the description.
I was going to show you the video. Here we go.
Video?
It's a video.
See?
Yeah.
So basically, on these iPads, it sort of shows you all the different...
There's the big one.
Nice to see they've got an up-to-date picture with its trains.
What else have we got? We've got...
Snowdonia.
Preston. Winter Gardens. The Grand Theatre. Funny Girls. The Isle of Man.
There it is, the Isle of Man.
Can't see it today, but that's what it looks like. And it's somewhere out there.
Somewhere in, oh look, you can zoom all the way around, look, and see where all the different things are.
There's Primark.
Yeah, there it is.
That's one of the many sites of Blackpool,
get
Primark.
Get your bargains, Primark.
What's down there? Greg's?
Greg's, yeah, Poundland.
KFC, yeah.
Burger King, McDonald's, yeah.
You'll notice one thing though, that there looks really nice and sunny because that was probably done in July. This is reality. Rain. There you go, I'll have a little look round. I'll show you some shots through the windows of what we can see. Thanks for that very educational.
Thank you, I hope you enjoyed it.
Look through Blackpool. Enjoy the view. In. Oh, there we go.
Brace the cold.
Are you ready?
It started to snow here.
It started to snow?
Yeah.
Ah! Here we go.
Oh my god.
It's not actually that windy today. We've just had reports of one lovely. Whoa! I say that and then I walk around the corner and the wind starts. We've had reports that there's 50 mile an hour winds coming tomorrow. So the chances of us getting on the big one tomorrow is probably quite minimal. You alright there, Charlotte?
Yeah.
Yeah, I spoke too soon when I said it wasn't windy. I'm not sure if you can hear me very well or not. Are you alright there? Welcome to the Blackpool Tower in February. I don't think we'll stay out here for very long. That's the top. There we go. It's not that bad.
It is.
There's the winter gardens. Let's go up a bit higher, shall we?
Higher wind speed.
Downstairs only, go around this boat. Ooh. I mean, you can't really see much from up here today. It's a bit of a bad day to do it. There you go, a bit of lift machinery. Do you want a bit of lift machinery?
Yeah.
What we got in there? Loads. It's not a very nice day for doing it, is it really? We'll come in the summer and we'll do another vlog when you can see a bit more. But we have got some more videos actually online from Blackpool Tower if you do want to see a little bit more of the view side of things. I mean, Merton did a great job when they painted all this up. Obviously this was all brown and dingy, whereas now it's a modern sort of experience. It's a lot better. There we go. No entry onto the next one. Must be too windy to go on there.
Not pirates.
Why pirates? Pirates. Because they are. It's a bit windy now. Bit windy. Yeah, I don't plan to stay out here for very long. You normally can go on this one as well, but no entry. And then on the top of that, there's literally a spiral staircase in the middle. What do you think to this?
I enjoy it because it's too hot.
Yeah, let's go back inside.
That sounds good.
Okay then, just to let you know, when we do get down to the bottom, you're going to be in our level 6 gift shop. The desk to the right will be able to assist you with the photos to hand before the 4D cinema if you do wish to view or purchase any of those.
Did you enjoy the Blackpool Tower?
I did, but it was a bit windy.
Yeah, it's a bit windy and it's a shame we couldn't really see as much today as normal. Let's have a look at the merch.
Milk chocolate seagull eggs, I look.
Seagull eggs? What?
Seagull eggs.
Are they real?
No, not real. We've got pebbles here, these look nice. Off the pebbles, off the beach, ready to chocolate.
Are they what, to eat?
Yeah.
They're not proper pebbles though, Cadbury's pebbles. I love that picture. It's like a screenshot that is from the 4D cinema. If you've ever seen it before, obviously there's no point in really filming the 4D cinema because you need 4D glasses. Shawn stating the obvious there. Got a nice state-of-the-art heater just behind us as well. There you go, state-of-the-art heater.
Now we're going to show you some merch.
We've got merch paradise.
We've got this mug with a tower.
See, I like the handle. I've not got that one, you know.
Yeah.
I've got that one. We're going to have a look in the ballroom.
There you go. Nice big mug.
How much are we talking for the mug?
This is, I don't know, because it hasn't got a price on it.
See, that one there is £10, I assume the other ones are.
Oh, here we go. £8.
£8.
That's a bargain.
So they're 10, they're 8. The giant mugs. This actually here is the real structure. This isn't just theming for the shop. It's actually the real structure for Blackpool Tower. You can hear the 4D cinema going off in there. Can you hear a bit of Kylie? All the lovers. Let's see through that gap. All your typical Merlin stuff. I mean, this was used to be owned by Leisure Attractions. There we go. Company, I think, like Leisure Attractions, Leisure Park, something like that. Used to own it prior to Merlin. Obviously, it's still owned by the council now, but it's operated by Merlin. I mean, I think they've done a great job with it, really. Modernised it up. I was saying to Charlotte while we were up there, it was all like brown and not very nice, whereas now they've painted it all up. It looks really nice. There we go. Attraction number one is done. We're going to make our way down to the dungeons now. Probably have a little look in the ballroom on the way down. You've been lit up there by that quality heater.
Oh, it's nice, that heater.
Yeah. That's it. Right, let's have a little walk downstairs. It's on like five different levels, the tower. Pretty sure it's five levels. Oh, they've got a Zoltar machine in here. Of course, like any Merlin attraction, you can leave your feedback at one of many. Customer service points, they're still that old school here. At Alton Towers, they've got the iPads now. Better than Madame Tussauds. Inside the ballroom. I mean, me and Charlotte were saying we might go and do some dancing. What do you think?
Yeah.
Do some dance lessons, or should we save that for in a few years when we can't quite do the theme park rides and attractions as much as we can do? It's now time for Charlotte's very first dungeon that she's ever done. How come you've never done a dungeon before?
I'm so scared.
It's crazy. I mean, it's very precise, especially this sign. I really like this one. It's got, of course, 10 actor shows, but 252 special effects. So I'm going to actually, as we're going through, I've done these dungeons probably about 10, 12 times over the years. And I'm going to count how many special effects there is. So, and see how many times Charlotte screams inside. What are you expecting from it in terms
of an
attraction?
I really doubt now. I'm expecting like a scare attraction.
It's not a scare attraction, no. It used to be. The original one in London was more of a scare attraction before they moved it from Tooley Street to where it is now at County Hall. But it's more of an experience. It's funny. There's some good innuendo in there. Innuendo bingo. Yeah, some good stuff in there. Yeah, it's really enjoyable. I think you'll really like it. And this has changed quite a bit. I've not done it for about a year and a half, this dungeon. The Viking scene, I believe, has now been replaced with a new scene. And also, there's a tavern at the end. There's a pub. So we'll be having a little look in that, and I believe we can get a bit of footage in the pub at the end. So we'll sit down in there, maybe have a drink, and give you our review. So here we go. We'll see you after we've been in the dungeons. We're going to have a horrible, horrible time. Let's go.
Let's go.
10 actor shows. Blackpool Tower Dungeon. So we've just come out of the dungeons. How did you find it?
I got picked on.
Oh, why? What scene did you get picked on?
It was like, there was like a dead body on the bed. And I had to,
in the doctor's?
I had to strap myself to this chair and he cut my body
out. Basically, you go into like a surgery scared. Because of the plague, because Charlotte's got the plague.
I've got the plague.
Yeah. So basically, she had to sit behind a curtain. It's really interactive, the dungeons. I mean, as I'm sure you know, if you've done any of them before. And she had to sit behind the curtain and then he slit your wrist, didn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah, have you got a mark from that?
He slit my wrist.
Oh.
And all the blood come out.
Yeah, what else did he do?
He hit me out of the head with an hammer and then he chopped my bits out.
Excuse me?
Well, that's what he said.
He said he likes pulling out the bits, didn't he? He liked pulling out your bits.
He pulled my bits out.
He's pulled my bits out before. But yeah, so we're inside the new tavern. I mean, this is nice. We'll have another closer look around here in a second. But yeah. What was your favourite scene?
Probably the scene I was in.
Yeah, you like that one. It's good theming. What do you think of the theming throughout?
I think it was really good. I've really enjoyed the dungeons.
Yeah. It's got some of the best theming that Merlin have done, I think.
Good.
But these are my favourite attractions from Merlin. I think they do a fantastic job of these. I actually prefer these to the theme parks. I think the quality, I mean, you look around in here, I think the quality of it is just fantastic, you know, theming-wise. Yeah, it looks brilliant. All the little details. Like the candle.
It was
bad, I must admit. That's one of the worst on my photos I've ever seen. She was there like this, but
it was horrible.
What were you doing? Come on, show us what you're doing.
I don't like drop
rides. She doesn't like them, does she? But it's basically the same sort of size as Subterra, so you've got that style of drop ride. It's also got the updated restraints, which I'm not sure if you did Subterra towards the end of the year, you'd have sort of seen the new restraints that it's got. But yeah, so they're quite restrictive now, which is a shame, but it used to be basically a lap bar, and it was quite exposed, which felt better for airtime and stuff. But still a good ride. My favourite scene in there, I really like the Caves of Skipple. I really like that. Of course, the new scene was better as well. Big shout out to Lauren, who was in there, brilliant actor, and she did a great job. I mean, that was a lot better than the old video, what the sort of play with the Vikings and stuff. I mean, I preferred this now. It's a lot better because there's two actors in there, someone in a barrel, and then the main actor. You're sort of fighting to stop the attack coming, really, now, which is better. Of course, the opening scene's really good as well with the jump scare. Yeah, it's really good. I'm going to give that run through that we had there in terms of actor quality. I'm going to give it a good 8 out of 10. I really enjoyed that.
I'm going to give it a 9 out of 10.
9 out of 10. For your first dungeon, do you want to go and do some more then now?
Yeah, I really enjoyed it.
We'll have to go down to London and you have to do that.
But I'll probably get picked on again.
Probably. I mean, the court scene's good as well. And obviously, I still like the torturer. What do you think to that? I mean, there is quite a lot of innuendo in there.
There is. And there's little kids in there, but I suppose.
It's family. What they say, no under 15, no under 12, or something like that. I mean, but yeah, this is nice, isn't it? This is brand new. I've not seen this. It opened last year. And London dungeons literally had a brand new one of these that opened towards the end of 2015 as well. I mean, look at it. Really good in here. Let's have a little look at what they do. Annual passes. Pulls out a dungeon. What have we got? Stella, £3.
He's looking at you.
Cocktails. Alcoholic, £3.25. Non-alcoholic, £2.75. Wine's got a bit of rosé for you. No Prosecco. Bottle pop, £1.80. That's more for a Shrek's orange juice, there you go. But yeah, so you enjoyed that?
Yeah, I really.
Well, right, we're going to have some lunch, I think, now before we go and do the rest of the attractions. So there you go. Nice, isn't it? I'll show you a couple of clips of the theming.
Yeah. Yeah.
Look at that. Nice, juicy jacket potato. How much was that, Charlotte?
£4.
£4 for that.
Let's just say the chips didn't come with it. It was just that tiny jacket potato.
£4 for that.
I've probably paid £4 for all the excess cheese they gave me on the plate that I didn't need.
Look at that, nice. Look at that high definition. That's a good way of showing how nice this new camera is. Look at the detail. I bet you just sat at home now wanting to go and eat that. What do you want to think I've had? Guess from the crumbs. Always fresh, always tasty, Greg's. I'm also going to show you one of my other favourites. I can't actually do it while I'm holding the camera, so Charlotte can.
I'm going to show you.
This is one of my favourite treats, this is.
What's it called?
Spiky Mikey.
Yeah, Spiky Mikey.
Let's get him on high definition for you.
Look at that, Spiky Mikey. Bit of a zoom. Let's try this zoom out.
There we go. You zoom in on that.
Look at that.
Yeah.
I can just see the viewers now licking the tongue, wanting to go out and grab that. Nice Greg Spiky Mikey there. And that wasn't £4, that was like 70p. But we're gonna head to Madame Tussauds next. It's also your first Madame Tussauds, isn't it? So we'll finish our lunch in Coral Island Cafe and we'll see you at Madame Tussauds. Weather's getting bad out there though now. Spiky. Tussauds Blackpool!
It's so lifelike!
You alright, Simon?
Really?
Have I got the X Factor?
No.
I can't believe you've never been to the Madame Tussauds before. Welcome to Take Me Out. We've got our first boy, Dan the Love Lift. Here he is. Life is a highway. I want to ride it all night long. Good evening, ladies. You're all looking gorgeous tonight.
Especially you.
I'm Shawn, and I'm all the way from your Toxeter. Thanks.
Who's a category?
The buttons, as I saw, I did a bit of customization. And here you've got like the interactive screens to play games. The good thing about Madame Tussauds in Blackpool is, unlike London, it's not too busy. Oh, what's this here? What you got? Oh, you're as bad as Mr. Lee Wood.
Jeremy Carl's not here.
Yeah, where is Jeremy? He's normally stood literally. You didn't even see the holes where he's normally stood. But we got the techie box.
Yeah.
Yeah, what we got on here?
Let's have a look.
Put something on the end of it.
I might sound like that.
Boom, boom. Buddy, we will rock you.
You're not bothered, are you? You don't give a damn.
Selfie stick. You didn't tell me you were bringing that.
What's wrong with it?
Selfie stick. That's quality. I like your phone case as well.
I've
Who is it?
I've
chewed. Oh, Minnie Mouse.
Yeah. You know what? I might sound like my old man, but you today. All right, well, let's do it. Thank you. You know what? I might. You know what? I might sound like.
We've changed the layout quite a bit in here. It's
all important DNA results.
DNA test. There you go. Get on the jazzy seat. Go on. You did it, Charlotte.
I can't believe it.
DNA test results coming up after the break. Escalator credit. Woo! Everybody loves an escalator credit to our favourite show. I'm a Celebrity.
Yeah,
yeah. Oh, I thought you were gonna let me down then. And Dad looked really young in there, waxwork model, as you'll see when we go round in a second. Model. Oh, that wasn't here last time. They've done like loads of improvements since I last came in here. That never used to exist. You can tell that's brand new as well. Who is it?
Stagwell.
Is it?
sweet. You like his hair, do you?
I wanted to feel if it was like real hair.
He's got a bogey.
It's so freaky, though. Come on, let's go into the. We've won. I'm a celeb. Not I'm a celeb. I'm a celebrity. Yeah. I'm a celebrity.
Big brother. Oh, we didn't care about that.
I'm doing the walk, I'm leaving camp.
I'll pretend that I'm your family and friends here, and then I'll be a camp mate, and then you walk across. Ready? Bye, Charlotte. Bye. Bye. See you next week when the show finishes. See ya. She's lasted 8 days in camp, and here she is. Out comes Charlotte Charteris from Birmingham. Shh. Where?
Oh, I missed you so much.
I missed you so much. Hey, you did well. Here you go. Post the photos. Just on the star. Follow me on the star.
I'm out. Oh, it feels so good to be out.
Does it?
It does.
You haven't been in anyway. You're in Madame Tussauds.
Oh, it feels so good to be out.
This is good. I like the bridge.
I love the bridge.
All it needs now is a bit of pyro coming off. Bit of pyro. Where's Ant and Dec? Are they still in the same place? Oh, they've moved. See, Ant and Dec used to be just here. Doom, 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 doom. Ah. This is a younger Ant and Dec. But which one's Ant and which one's Dec?
I'm doing my favourite person now.
See, Dec looks quite good.
And looks
lovely. No. There you go. Sit down on the chair for me.
Okay, I'm ready for my.
Gonna give you your first food. So you can either have this one over here, which is the imaginary hot dog and chips from Wetherspoons. Six chips. Or you can have this. What do you think?
I'm gonna go for these.
You're gonna go for these? Two of those and one star for Cam. Oh, one more. There you go. I'm going to do my bush trucker trial now.
I'm a celebrity, get me out of here.
I'm not doing that again. I must say that is a vast improvement. Okay, Charlotte, time for your next trial. This will be, how many holes have we got? Five holes, five stars for camp. Number one. Now we sit down, off you go. What can you feel in there? Oh! What is he in there? What you got?
I don't know, I'm passing.
Cockroaches in that one. What's in this one? That's it, I need another star from this one. Get your hand right in there. Get your hand right in there, come on.
Oh, I can't.
Give it one more go, Charlotte, for camp. Here we go.
Oh, I can't like it.
Two more
camp,
left.
The camp can starve.
You're not doing it?
No, I'm a celebrity. Get me out of here.
Oh. Alcohol. There's Beckham, just having a chill out.
Chilling, mate.
Is that a bit of Adidas there as well? Hey, Adidas or Adidas? Definitely Adidas.
Adidas.
Alex did well, don't you think? Did you see the challenge? He did well. I was really proud of him. Just to make you all aware, he wasn't actually in any pain whilst we were filming that. Alex, what he hasn't told you is he actually goes to college and he's about to go to university as a drama actor. So I think he put on quite a good show there. He wasn't genuinely in any pain. No Alex crumps were hurt during the filming of that vlog. Lewis Hamilton. That's a really good one, actually. It means with this camera I can get some really nice close-ups and stuff. I mean, when we get on to Pleasure Beach tomorrow, hopefully the weather's going to be good and I'll be able to get some really nice coaster shots for you. I mean, in terms of quality, I mean, look at the faces on this new camera. It really picks up things really well. So hopefully when we're filming these vlogs, the idea is to make it feel like you're with us, with me and Charlotte having the fun.
Yeah.
But obviously now, it's going to really feel like you're with us with our new camera equipment. Coronation Street.
I love Coronation Street.
Can we go and have a picture of them?
The Rovers return in.
I'm
going
to walk in and start a scene.
We'll do that. You're going to start a scene. I mean, this is great, especially with Coronation Street fans. Something that Charlotte is, and I like Coronation Street, but I just don't really have the time to watch it.
Oh my
gosh. There you go. This is nice. Who's that sat in there? Nice tribute to
this way.
Jack and Vera. So detailed. Get your merchandise.
I can feel it coming in the air tonight. Hold on, hold on.
You get a day with me in Blackpool.
Yeah. Please. Please. Now I'm going to play for you now. Peace out and Montreal.
To Charlotte off camera, when we get a house, we're going to have a drum set.
We won't be having a drum set.
Go and stand in there, let's see what you look like with a telephone on your head. Here she is. Lady Gaga, hello. I'd love to count how many mailing attractions there are in the world that have these labyrinths. I mean, there's loads on. See where Charlotte is, I can see her there. Is that a mirror? Yeah. Where are you? Is that really you? Where's she gone? Is that you?
It's me.
Well, we're gonna have a funny photo now on this funny photo point. That's quite a funny photo point you can have there, because obviously you sit on a deck chair. Oh, this is a vast improvement.
Oh,
isn't
it? Let me take a photo of you like
that. Hello, I'm Shawn and welcome to Theme Park Worldwide on YouTube in the 5th anniversary 2016 at Madame Tussauds Blackpool.
Look how small we are.
There you go. Hiya.
Shimmy. Shake that booty. But yeah, it's quite a good photo point. You sit on a big deck chair and then you get glasses and stuff. Nice up south in the annual pass there. What we got there is Nemesis. It's an out of date photo though, that now, with its beautiful new track paint for this year. We'll check that out, of course, in Alton Towers vlog when the park opens in March next month. Time for the best of British now. Just going to see the Queen. See, that's a good one of the Queen. Her Majesty. There's my crown. I'm going to go and stand next to my family. You alright there? Hi, how's the new baby? You alright? What? What's that? Yeah, you're on YouTube, yeah. YouTube, think about worldwide.
Ayo!
How you doing? You're still getting on, yeah, after all these years? Oh gosh, I am indeed! Where's my best friend, Mr. Lee Wood? He normally comes to see me, Madame Tussauds. Oh, I'm sorry, Your Majesty, he's not here today, but he's at Blackpool Pleasure Beach in the vlog tomorrow, along with Joe and other people that you might know and recognise from the vlogs.
Oh, that is fantastic. Oneself will be watching that again soon. And how is Charlotte?
I'm brilliant.
Oh, that's good to see. Well, you get on and enjoy the rest of your day.
See ya.
Goodbye.
Here's everyone's favourite, the ogre himself, Shrek. How you doing, Shrek? This is a huge one. I mean, look at that. Look at the size. I can get my hand in his mouth. I mean, Shrek's Adventure is a fantastic attraction that Merlin have opened sort of in collaboration with DreamWorks in London. And it's really good. What do you think of Shrek?
It's
good, isn't it? We'll have to take you down to London and go and do the Shrek's Adventure. I mean, it's really good. All right, there. This looks so tasty. I'm sure he belongs in Greg's, though. 80p from Greg's.
No, it's too cute to eat.
You reckon?
I would like to eat.
Bob the Builder. Just the little effects I like obviously the music's on and the lighting. There's also another photo opportunity with Spider-Man, which is quite good. And this is pretty much the end, last scene. Russell Brand. That's Madame Tussauds. What do you think to that?
I'm
for your first time doing one. Obviously, it's not the biggest one, Blackpool. London is bigger, but as I said earlier on in the vlog, you really struggle to sort of get around that one and get photos with the waxworks that you want to. It's always just so busy. Obviously, with it being in the centre of London, Baker Street, you know, it just gets rammed all the time. What was your favourite one in there?
Oh. My favourite one was... I don't know, I don't think I've got
it. We wanted to see Jeremy Kyle, and obviously he was out for refurbishment.
And he's having work done.
Yeah, he needs it there after all that stress. I mean, he's broke up with his wife as well, hasn't he?
He's got the stress.
Yeah.
But, Sean...
Maybe she's beat him up and you need to see, you know, need sorting out.
An award.
You want an award? What's that for? Best girlfriend?
I was going to say amazing boyfriend. There you go.
I wouldn't win that, I don't think.
You would.
You think? Maybe.
Yeah.
You get engraved, look. Any celebrity award purchase. So you could get like...
Oh, that's
some,
nice.
See, that's a good one.
I like the microphone.
If someone's a good
nice.
Singer, you could be like best singer or something. Yeah, who's your favourite that you saw? You got to have a favourite or favourite part of it.
Ollie Mears.
I enjoy playing the drums, to be fair.
Oh, cool.
How much is this big one here? Is that the same? Of course, like any other Merlin attraction, T-shirts, mugs, shot glasses, everything. Pretty much got all these there, I think. You can have a great day in Blackpool though without hardly spending anything if you've got a Merlin pass. I mean, well, even if you haven't, the big ticket, I'm not sure on the exact prices, but check out the website for these Merlin attractions. Wait, Timber. And you will be able to have a good day out. It's a good weekend, do Pleasure Beach and obviously a day of Merlin.
September. It's going down, Charlotte.
It's going down.
I'm yelling timber. One Direction, that's for Lee. I've got Lee's birthday present sorted here then. You want some Harry stuff? Where's the Harry? Timber. There we go, so that's Madame Tussauds. On to our next attraction, which I believe is going to be Sea Life. It's good, this one. You've done Sea Life before, haven't you?
Yeah.
Just not this one. So we'll see you down there. Party! Timber. So here we are in the Blackpool Sea Life. This is probably the best one, I would say, in the country. I mean, I'm not a big fan of the London one. As I don't really like the building, but it's in inside County Hall. I mean, a lot of the ceilings are quite exposed, whereas in here, all the ceilings are themed in quite nice with the sections, or pretty much all of them anyway. Birmingham one's nice, but you seem to be going up a lot of levels and stuff there in Birmingham.
Yeah.
Whereas this one's a bit more...
It's not very big, though.
A bit more flat.
I can't tell if that's a Ferrari.
Going on about the camera quality again, I mean, you look at this now. It looks a lot better than what you'd see before. Like, in these dark conditions, the old sort of camera equipment was struggling a little bit. But now it's good. Also, we've got a night shot on this camera as well.
He's coming, the big daddy's coming.
Oh, that ain't the big daddy.
Is that a lobster?
The little mummy, that is.
Oh, look, he's caught in the net.
No, oh, he's caught for your tea tonight. That's what you're having for
I'd like to try a lobster, you know.
No, oh, there you go, that fish has just knocked him.
Come on, come on out.
But yeah, we've got a night shot on this camera as well, so it does mean that attractions such as Space Mountain at Disney, we can sort of film on ride with that. And instead of it just being dark, you'll actually get to see stuff. So the low vision recording, so that'll be great. Right, let's have a look around. Yeah, little fishy. She reminds me of the mermaid that's on the front of the ship in Alton Towers Hotel.
I've just heard that.
Was you? Is that reading your mind?
Yeah.
You've got some really cool like projectors in here, projecting like little facts on the floor. Clever. Little things, simple but effective. Obviously, you've never been to a Sea Life before. They're all sort of split into different theme sections. You've also got these little screens. They used to be just like plaques that are lit up, but now they're all screens, sort of telling you the information. Some of them are interactive and things. So it makes it a lot better for knowing what animals you're looking at, really. There's quite a few people around Blackpool today, though, for a Saturday in, you know, in February. I think this is the busiest. Yeah. I mean, a lot of people, we say that just as we come around the corner and there's no one. maybe a lot of people came for Pleasure Beach, because obviously it's closed today. Normally it was on the Saturday, this year it's opened on the Sunday. It's been private hired by the scouts today. But we believe also, well, we've seen photos, the big one's actually stalled today on its final section in the tunnel, just by the on-ride photo point. It's actually stalled before coming back into the station, so that's definitely not going to be on tomorrow now. Obviously, if it gets too windy, it's off, but it must have been too windy when they were testing it this morning for the private hire. But we'll see how responsive Blackpool are tomorrow at getting that back open. You never know, it could be back open in the morning. Stuff in Blackpool since I last came. Obviously with Madame Tussauds there's been a lot of improvements that we've seen in the vlog. The Dungeons has had a new scene and also the tavern head on the end. This is a brand new tank. Well, I say brand new, I've not seen it and I've not been here for about a year, I would say, in these attractions. Oh, echo. But yeah, I mean, look at this. Looks great. It's good to see Merlin investing a lot in these midways. I do think the midways are sort of looked after better than the theme parks, really. I mean, the midway attractions are fantastic. There you go. Getting the temperature or something up there. You can definitely tell Merlin's heart lies within its midway attractions. They're fantastic. I mean, the new Shrek's brilliant. All the dungeons I absolutely love. And stuff like the Sea Life. As much as I'm not really an animal person, I do enjoy it. You're right there.
I love stingrays.
They're nice, aren't they?
I like the little face.
I was just saying to the viewers, it's a new tank, this
one. It's lovely, this thing. You could sit here, Craig.
And here we see a wild species, the Charlotte, in a natural habitat. Doing nothing, under the water.
What's that?
I've never seen a piranha.
It's gonna come and bite you.
Yeah, you don't know.
These are dangerous. I mean, you look at them. They look nice and gentle, chilling out.
There you go. Oh,
danger. Flesh eating piranha.
Red belly piranha.
You won't want to put your hand in there.
Kissing,
love.
He's too kissy.
Oh, it's me and you,
that is. It's me and you. Oh, he's just beating up. Oh.
There's been a few people that have commented on quite a few of the vlogs in the past asking if me and Charlotte are dating.
Yes.
We've been together for nearly 3 years. Two and a half, nearly 3 years. I don't think we've actually ever mentioned that in a vlog.
No, we haven't.
So for the people that do comment and ask if we're dating, you never know. We're not dating, we're in a relationship. Whoa! Sharp mission. What do you think of the sea life centre?
It was really nice, it was really well themed. It's quite a long one as well.
It is one of the best ones. The theming, you can't fault the theming in there though, can you really?
It was really good.
There we go, we're going on Merlin's Pirate Adventure Golf
now.
I've
never played Adventure Golf.
I can't believe it. Like, how come you never done some of this stuff as a kid?
I've probably done it when I was younger, but I can't remember playing Adventure Golf.
No.
No.
There you go. This is quite well themed as well. Well, it's basically, have you not done it at Strawberry Golf Alton Towers either?
No.
You're joking?
No.
We'll have to do that at some point.
I would never be bothered.
But yeah, Pirate Adventure Golf. See, this is a typical park coming to the seaside, and I will be having an ice cream at some point.
Yeah.
It's got to be done. It's quite well themed, so we're going to have a go on this. This is also included on your mailing pass, so. It used to be an old shopping complex.
You're going to have to show me what to do, because I don't have a
car. I'll give you some rules, and we'll take you guys along for a bit of a journey as well. I won't bore you too much by watching us play golf and get really competitive. It's good, because you got this lower section, then it goes like upstairs around there and stuff. Quite good. All right, let's give it a go. Pirate golf.
Sean's going to hit his shot. Where's he going to go?
That's it.
Whoa.
Oh, we're in a bit of a ditch here. Yeah, I'm going to get all professional now.
He's going to get professional. He's took the pole out the hole. Come on.
Oh! Oh! It's going to be a three, isn't it? That was close.
Four. Well done.
It was a bit disappointing.
It's now my turn.
Let's see how Charlotte does. Here we go. She's off, golf champion. Where is it? Where's it gone?
Sovereign.
Oh, you've gone off the course. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Oh, okay. How am I supposed to get it out of there?
Okay. Whack it. Two. Three. Come on, let's get it back on. Four. Five. Concentrate. She won me on the last hole. Two for four. What's that now? Five. Six.
Six.
We're about even then now, I think. Yeah, that means we're even because you won me on the last hole. It's quite well themed on here. Can't believe you never played mini golf. What have you been doing all your life? Not playing mini golf, obviously. We've got a little scorecard here.
So what did I get? Six.
So you got six? Yeah, we're even now, look. Are we?
You've got six, I've got 10. So you're winning.
Oh. Plenty of holes to go. Every hole's a goal. Eight. That's number eight, that one. Number nine. Well, tell the viewers what you did on the last hole.
I did a hole in one.
Hole in one, and then he's just got an eye on this one. Concentrate. Play the game. Let's go upstairs.
Are you sure that was nine?
That was definitely nine. I don't want any cheating on that scorecard.
You're losing me.
I don't want no losing.
I've
got four most of them. Tell you what, this is a low ceiling, isn't it? It's like Tower of the Towers.
Oh,
yes.
Oh my God.
It's a bit tight up here. Don't mind though. Hole seven, the golden doubloon. You ready for the golden doubloon?
I'm so ready.
It's themed up here, look at this. It's good. Okay, let's have a look and see how I do with this one.
Right, here we go.
Where's it gone?
Oh dear. What? Probably two.
Two?
Not bad, not bad. It's going to be a three, I think. Where's the flag in this one?
It's gone.
In an awkward position. It's a three.
It's a three.
Let's see how Charlotte does with this one. Here she goes. I'll move if it starts coming up here, like that.
That was
good. You did well there. You should get this in two if you concentrate. Take your time. No pressure.
You've pressured me now.
I've pressured you. What's that? Four. Five. I can't count that.
You can't. Five.
That was five, yeah.
Five. I'm losing.
You just need to take your time. Wait for your balls to stop before you start rolling them again.
Oh.
More careful with your balls. Look after your balls better, basically.
I will.
It's a tip for you to take into all the life, that. Davy Joe. I like the music in here, but do you recognise this bit of theming from Shark Bay Reef, Alton Towers in Meany Bay? Charlotte's coming. Oh my God, where's the ball? It's behind your treasure chest. Some low light levels in it, I can't really see much. You got it. It's two. Should be a three, this one. Oh, if that was a bit harder, it'd have been in. Oh, Charlotte, take your time. It's a four.
It's a four.
I think I'm going to win this one, you know. We not fell out, though. Well, guess where it's drawing me golf? 18 holes of pleasure, that is.
Not yet, we haven't found out.
Ooh. Still time, still another hole, I think, downstairs.
Well done, Ace!
What's that, two?
It's one.
So the next part of our vlog takes us to Coral Island, one of the massive arcades in Blackpool, one of the biggest arcades I've ever been in really, and this, Pirate's Quest Ghost Train. This used to be just a standard ghost train, and then they rethemed it to Pirate's Quest, and it opened without the ghost train sign up, and then they decided to call it a ghost train again and put the sign back up. So price of this one, two riders, £3, or a single rider, £2. It's quite a short ride, but it's good, quite well themed. So we're going to give this one a little ride through. Come on for the ride on this one, and we'll give you a bit of a review after as well. Oh, he's scared.
not really.
No. It's not quite as good as Blackpool's classic ghost train, but it's all right.
There we go. Oh, do you want me to do it? I'll do it.
Charlotte's paying, isn't she? No. Taking your money?
Not accepting it.
We'll sort this out and then we'll get on.
Let me out!
Oh my
god! Look out below!
Please keep your arms away from the side.
Beware, you're about to meet the captain. Get off my ship and don't come back.
Yeah, it gets scary now. Charlotte. What? Why?
I was terrified.
I think the viewers could probably hear your screams, to be honest.
That was so scary.
Oh, I thought it was good. I mean, it's well themed. It lasts about 2 minutes. You saw pretty much all the ride on the footage anyway that I got. I really like that. It's well themed. It's a lot better than it used to be. It's one of the best ghost shrines in the UK, that is. Trains, Sean. Learn how to speak. I'm that cold, my lips are like... We're going on a more family ride now, shall we? Let's go on the monorail. Pirate Flyer, here it is. This is more your sort of ride, isn't it, Charlotte? You go round, see them targets in the ceiling? You shoot them targets in the ceiling. Let's go, there's another one. £3, single rider, £2. Let's go. There's Billy Bones. Welcome to Brilliance, which is basically a disco in the street. He's just been chucking it down. The car coming down, I don't think he should really be driving down. It's basically, this is how crazy Blackpool is. There's a street with shops at either side. Flats. I mean, what do you make of this? It's a bit random, isn't it? Go west! And they have like loads of different shows. It's quite cool. This is what I wanna do. Give us a dance. What have I done to deserve this? What have I done to deserve this? I mean, how random could Blackpool get? Have you enjoyed your day in Blackpool, Charlotte? What's been your highlight of the day? Obviously, we've done all the million attractions, a few other little bits. What's been your highlight?
Being chosen in the dungeon.
Being picked on in the surgeon. You really like that?
Yeah.
What was your favourite attraction out of all the ones we did today?
Probably the dungeons.
So that means a trip to London, Edinburgh, San Francisco, York. All the other dungeons, York. How can I forget York? Brilliance is quite cool, though. The random Blackpool. It's random, isn't it? Like millions of pounds spent in the street. My highlight of the day for me, this trip today, it's been seeing Charlotte's first reactions to everything here in Blackpool. I mean, I'm glad you really like the dungeon. You know how much I love the dungeon. Obviously, back at the World of Theme Park, it's in my shed, basically. I've got the original stocks from the London dungeon. I absolutely love them. So it's been great. Glad you've had a good day.
Yeah.
Of course, Blackpool Pleasure Beach tomorrow. We've got all the classic vlog people coming along, pretty much all of them. It's going to be a great day. You're looking forward to it?
Yes.
Charlotte's second time at the Pleasure Beach. We'll see you there tomorrow. That's the end of this vlog. Glad you've enjoyed it. Thank you for watching, and I hope you've also enjoyed our brand new camera. We'll put this to the test with some coaster footage tomorrow, I think. So let's hope for better weather tomorrow. That means it's time to cue those credits. See you later, guys, from Brilliance Blackpool.
See ya.
Ta-ra. Thank you.